Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome to another segment of the Movie Reviews. Today's movie is the 2011 werewolf film Red Riding Hood. Okay, no smart remarks. Yes, I saw it. As a matter of fact, I wanted to see it. I like werewolf films, guys, and believe it or not, you know, you have vampires, zombies, and werewolves, but werewolf films are the hardest to get right. Think about it. It's true. The hardest to get right. And basically, the least amount of films of the three are made about werewolves. But anyway, this film stars Amanda Seyfried, and hopefully I'm saying that right, because if not, I don't really care. But it was directed by Catherine Hardwicke, and I have the page up on my computer screen now, guys, if you wondering, is he reading that? I am. But anyway, I'm not reading it. I'm looking at the information. But Catherine Hardwicke also directed the first Twilight film, and we'll get into that a little bit later. But basically in this story, guys, the plot goes as follows. You have this village called Daggerhorn, which lies on the edge of the haunted Black Forest. Now, for hundreds of years, the villagers have been threatened by werewolves. So to appease the werewolves and keep the peace, they are sacrificing their livestock to the wolves so that the wolves don't move in and enjoy a little bit of human food. Tastes like chicken. But the truce is broken. One of the werewolves goes rogue and starts feeding on the villagers. I mean, you can only eat livestock for, you know, thousands of years before it gets old. But with the truce broken, the village becomes ensnared by the werewolf and basically a prisoner of the werewolf. Everyone's living in fear. They finally get angry and go out and try to kill the werewolf, and they bring back this wolf, this head that they mounted on a pole that they believe to be the werewolf. But at the same time, the priest of the village is called in Gary Oldman's character. You know, he's just a really head of the church type of guy, the leader of the church, whose wife he had to actually kill, who changed into a werewolf. And he takes over the village, proclaims martial law, and he's going to discover who is the werewolf, which he decides is someone in the village. So, Amanda Seyfried plays the heroine in the film. She has two suitors in the movie that she has an affection for, and they're both vying for her love. So basically, you have this story which pretty much mirrors the first Twilight film, and given that this film was directed by Catherine Hardwicke, it's not surprising that this is a remake of Twilight with werewolves in the title role. But it's also very, very sad, because who wants to see a werewolf movie like Twilight? I mean, who wants to see Twilight? But, guys, I found this film, and I'm just going to be frank with you, a waste of fucking time. I mean, other than Gary Oldman being in this film, who's tour de force, who turns in this great performance, and even his characters are smuck, but other than his inspiring role in this film, the rest of the film is just utterly waste. I mean, you have the beautiful Amanda Seyfried in the film, who plays the damsel in distress. She has this affinity to understand the werewolf. He speaks to her. Did I say that? Did I make that up? Oh yeah, that wasn't a movie. He does speak to her. She can understand the werewolf, who transmit mental telepathy to her. And she's trying to choose between these two guys, who one she kind of leans towards, but the other one she kind of admires his level head and the fact that he's a more stable type guy. But you know, girls always go for the rough and ready and the guys with the bad boy temper, and you know, like me. But anyway, guys, basically, like I said, you have a story like Twilight. Gary Oldman comes in, he's going to capture the werewolf, he's going to kill whoever gets in his way, he's going to accuse Amanda Seyfried's character of being a witch. You just, I mean, guys, the worst thing about this film is the fact that it's a mirror image of Twilight. There's nothing original about this film, and when you watch it, if you've seen Twilight, it's just, you're sitting there and you're thinking, What the fuck? If I wanted to see Twilight, I would go see Twilight. Why do we need to see that in a film called Red Riding Hood, which in itself to me is kind of silly, given that Red Riding Hood is a children's story? Now, that's not why I didn't like the film, guys. I mean, fine, they want to call it Red Riding Hood, fine. But in my eyes, seeing Amanda Seyfried in a red cloak and a little picnic basket going to Grandma's house, what big eyes you have. And that is in the movie, guys. But the whole concept to me is just silly. It would have been much better if they'd have just called it something else. But I got to tell you guys, the acting in this film by everyone except for Gary Oldman is pretty uninspiring. The two guys that are the suitors for Amanda Seyfried's character, they are a fucking bore. It's like they're just sleepwalking through the film. It's like they're not convincing at all. And this is just one of those movies, guys, that you're going to watch and then the next day you're just going to forget entirely about it. It was not what I was expecting. It was a total disappointment. Other than the setting, the sets, the cinematography, that was the best thing about the movie. I mean, and another thing that's kind of strange about the film is when you look in the village, it's always snowing. But none of the people in the village have coats on or any kind of heavy clothing, animal skins, anything. So that in itself was kind of strange to me. Now, the film, guys, cost $42 million to make. It made, I think, $82 million, $89 million, and that's domestic and worldwide, or international, so that's not very good. It wasn't a very big hit. It got like 11% rating on Rotten Tomatoes, and it's just a film that is just totally uninspired. The characters seem bored out of their wits, and it also turns into kind of a who is the werewolf, a mystery. And guys, I figured right off the bat who the werewolf was because, you know, usually in these whodunits or who is it stories, the emphasis is always on other characters. And usually all those characters is not the person that you're wanting to believe they are. So I knew right off the bat who the werewolf was, so there was no surprise. And I don't know, guys. It's just a movie that we didn't need this movie. So I'm going to say avoid this movie. I'm definitely not going to recommend it. Uninspired performances, a lousy soundtrack, just totally lousy music. Other than the set design, the special effects, as far as the village, the CGI on the village, the CGI on the wolf isn't all that great either. So this film just fails on so many levels. And I hear that it has a following, a little following, but I don't know why. Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. And avoid this film if you can. If you can't, just watch it one time. What the hell was that? Anyway, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I'll see you at the next video. Thought I was going to say movie review, didn't you? Take care, everybody.